Welcome back to another timing system installation video by Cloyes. I'm Cody Smith, Technical Product Director for Cloyes. In this video, we'll be demonstrating timing system removal and installation in Chrysler 3.2 and 3.6 liter V6 Pentastar engines. The Cloyes kit we are installing today is used in various Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, Ram, Volkswagen, Lancia, and Fiat models starting in 2011, and the engine is still in production today. There are two versions of this engine, the later version starting in some 2016 models that included updates to the chains and sprockets. The kit we are installing today is the 9-0511S kit, which is for the earlier version engine, but this installation guide will apply to both. The kit includes the primary, oil pump, and secondary chains, primary, oil pump, and secondary tensioners, all the necessary chain guides, and the idler, crankshaft, and oil pump sprockets. The kit is also available without sprockets by adding an X to the end of the kit number. Coming in 2024, Cloyes is launching a complete timing kit for the later version Pentastar engines, and a complete VVT kit for the earlier version engines that will include the timing components, VVT camshaft phasers, oil control valves, and the solenoids. To view all the current kit offerings, confirm which kit is correct for your vehicle, and find additional product information, please visit our part finder at cloyes.com. The timing components in most Chrysler Pentastar applications can be serviced with the engine in the vehicle. But to access and service the primary and oil pump chains, you must remove the engine's upper and lower oil pans, which can require a lot of disassembly. Once the oil pan, the valve covers, and the timing cover are removed, you need to rotate the engine to number one, top dead center, on the exhaust stroke. You can find this position easily by rotating the crank until the dimple on the crankshaft aligns to the point where the top of the front main bearing cap and the engine meet on the right bank of the engine, the left-hand side as you're looking at it. This places the engine at number one top dead center, but you need to inspect the cams to determine the stroke. Make sure the arrows on the left bank phasers are pointing at each other and the lines on the right bank phaser are aligned. If these marks are opposite, rotate the crank one full revolution and check again. Another quick check is to make sure the holes in all four camshafts are facing upward. With the engine in this position, you're at top dead center number one on the exhaust stroke, and you're ready to start disassembly. There are special tools available that will lock the camshafts in these positions and can make the job easier, but they are not necessary and we're not using them during this demonstration. If you're servicing the timing system due to a system failure and you cannot position the shafts as directed, you can disregard the engine position for now and start the disassembly process. Just note that if the engine is out of time, it is possible that you may have damaged the valves due to interference with the pistons. Before reassembly, you'll need to rotate the crankshaft to a position where no pistons are at top dead center, rotate the camshafts to properly align them as shown, and then bring your crankshaft mark back to the alignment with the top of the main bearing cap. With the shafts all located correctly, you would then be ready to reassemble. Start the disassembly process by removing the oil pump chain tensioner. Then remove the oil pump sprocket bolt, which is a T45 Torx, and remove the sprocket and oil pump chain. Next, remove the left and right hand secondary tensioners using a T30 socket. Using the same socket, you can now remove the chain guide from the right hand bank. Now, starting with the right bank, remove the exhaust phaser. Do this by using a 1 1/8 wrench or metric equivalent on the hex feature of the camshaft and a 36 millimeter socket on the oil control valve. Once the phaser is separated from the camshaft, you can disengage and remove the secondary chain from the engine. Repeat the process on the left bank. Remove the remaining secondary guides and the primary tensioner and guide. Then you can remove the idler sprocket bolt and washer and remove the primary chain and sprockets. If you are replacing the intake camshaft phasers, now is the time to do so. Remove the oil control valves, replace the phasers, making sure they index onto the camshafts properly, and torque the new control valves to 110 foot-pounds. The camshaft phasers in this application are fed oil through the center of the camshafts. This oil is controlled by the VVT solenoids that are mounted in the valve covers, which interact with the oil control valves that act as the phaser bolts. The Cloyes VVT kit, available in 2024, will come with new phasers, solenoids, and control valves, and we recommend the replacement of all three component types during a full VVT system service. The solenoid and control valves are the same for all four camshafts, and you'll receive two intake and two exhaust phasers, which work on both the left and right banks. To service the VVT solenoids, remove and replace them from the valve cover before reassembly. Torque the bolts to 35 inch-pounds. If you are reusing or reinstalling tensioners that have already been activated, you will need to deactivate them before reassembly. The primary and right-hand tensioners just need to be compressed and pinned. A paper clip or something similar will work if you do not have the correct pins. The left-hand tensioner requires you to disengage the ratcheting mechanism before compressing. Do this with a small flat-tip screwdriver, prying the mechanism cylinder away from the stem and compressing at the same time. Once fully compressed, insert the activation pin. The use of a vise will make this process easier. We can now start the assembly process. Begin by assembling the primary chain, crankshaft sprocket, and the idler sprocket. Notice that the primary chain has a marked link on both sides. Align a marked link to the mark on the crankshaft sprocket on the smaller row of teeth, then flip the chain and sprocket and align the other marked link to the dot on the idler sprocket on the large row of teeth. Install the primary chain assembly onto the crankshaft and idler post, making sure that the crankshaft key stays in place. Install and torque the idler bolt and washer to 18 foot-pounds. Install the primary chain guide and tensioner. Tighten the bolt to 106 inch-pounds, which is almost 9 foot-pounds. Make sure the crankshaft mark is still aligned with the top of the main cap and the visible timing mark is at 12 o'clock. If so, activate the tensioner. Install the right bank tensioner guide, the left bank tensioner guide, and the left bank chain guide. Torque all bolts to 106 inch-pounds. Next, install the left bank secondary chain. Align the unique marked link of the primary chain to the arrow pointing to the middle row of teeth on the idler sprocket, and the two similarly marked links to the marks on the camshaft phasers. With the marks all aligned properly, engage the exhaust camshaft phaser with the camshaft. Slight movement of the camshaft may be required to align the indexing pin. Once engaged, install the oil control valve hand tight. Repeat the process on the right bank using the front row of teeth of the idler sprocket. Install the right bank chain guide, right bank tensioner, and the left bank tensioner. Torque all bolts to 106 inch-pounds. Check to make sure the three marks of both secondary chains are still aligned properly. If so, activate the right and left bank tensioners. Torque the oil control valves to 110 foot-pounds. Now you can install the oil pump chain. The oil pump chain does not need to be timed, just make sure to properly index the oil pump sprocket. Torque the sprocket bolt to 18 foot-pounds. Finally, install the oil pump chain tensioner. Make sure the end of the leaf spring is sitting on top of the dowel. You are now ready to reinstall the oil pan, the timing cover, and the valve covers. Please follow the proper procedures on applying gasket sealant to the covers and torque all the bolts appropriately. Like always, thanks for watching. If you have any questions, please contact our tech line. And to stay up to date on all things Cloyes, including tech and product information, and more videos like this one, please sign up for ShopMasters at Cloyes.com.